Welcome to this quick video on how you can use the 3D Experience platform and SOLIDWORKS Desktop for your at-home first robotics challenges.
Dassault Systems has two student sponsorship options. You have the option to use the 3D Experience platform, SOLIDWORKS Desktop, or you can apply for both. For more information, check out our student sponsorship page. All of the links in this video will be included in the description below. For those of you using the 3D Experience platform, I'm going to highlight a few ways you can use the platform to keep your team organized and optimize your design.
Once you've requested your license via the FIRST Robotics competition page on edu.3ds.com and completed the registration form, you will receive an email invitation for the 3D Experience platform. Just click the link and log in. Once you are on the platform, you will have access to several dashboards, communities, and apps. You will immediately be added to the FIRST Robotics competition dashboard. On the Discover tab, you can explore different communities like the 3D Experience EDU student community, where you can ask questions and learn about new challenges.
This community is open to everyone, even if you aren't using the platform.
The Learn tab is filled with a bunch of tutorials to help you get started. You can find all of the apps here on the Roles, Apps, and Solutions portfolio pane. One of the apps you can use is the Inovia Project Planning app. You can scroll down to find it or use the search bar. You can create a new project, add your members, and assign tasks. This app is super helpful for keeping a schedule and divvying up responsibilities so you and your team can divide and conquer this competition. The next app I want to show you is XDesign. XDesign is a cloud-based CAD program that allows you and your team to work on parts and assemblies collaboratively from anywhere. Make sure you have already set up a collaborative space for your team to create new components in. Once you have a design, you can analyze your model using the Design Guidance tab. You can use Design Guidance to redesign an existing part or create a whole new part based on the geometry and physical conditions of your existing assembly. Here is a quick overview of the Design Guidance tool. Use the clamp to define the part's degrees of freedom, then apply a load type and magnitude. I am going to redesign an existing part, so I'm now selecting the scope of the part that I would like redesigned. I then preserve a few regions that I don't want to change. This is great for preserving the geometry of mating faces. XDesign then generates a new model that shows you where your material is the most important for this use case. Be sure to simulate multiple use cases and factor your results into a new iteration.
Next up is SOLIDWORKS Desktop. I'm going to highlight a few ways you can use SOLIDWORKS to take your project to the next level. If you are using SOLIDWORKS Desktop and the platform for your project, you can connect to SOLIDWORKS from the SOLIDWORKS Connector app on the platform. This allows you to use SOLIDWORKS Desktop, but still save your progress in a collaborative space on the platform that your team has access to.
After you've designed and modeled your parts in SOLIDWORKS, you can go a step further and animate your assembly using the Mate Controller. By defining the positions of mates at different times, you can make a quick and easy animation. This can be super helpful for defining the movement of your robot or for animating critical moments of your game design challenge. Lastly, it's important to keep accurate cost projections and bill of materials throughout your project. If you're fabricating some of your parts yourself, you can estimate the materials cost for each part by checking the mass properties and multiplying the mass or volume by your materials cost. You can save the cost of each part in the costing tab and generate reports. You can also easily generate a bill of materials to keep track of all the parts you need. This wraps up my quick overview of some of the tools you can use in your first robotics challenges. There are tons of resources available to learn the tools that I mentioned. Check out the 3D Experience onboarding series for tutorials on the platform, and check out my.solidworks.com for help with SOLIDWORKS Desktop. Thanks for watching and good luck!